Rise, dark girls.
I can remember being in the bathtub asking my mom to put bleach in the water so that my skin would be lighter and so that I could escape the feelings that I had about not being as beautiful, as acceptable, as lovable.
If we're all just hanging around and a dark-skinned girl will pass by, they'll be, oh, well, she's pretty for a dark-skinned girl. And I'm like, what is that supposed to mean?
I used to wish that I can wake up one day lighter or wash my face and think that it will change. I thought it was dirt and I tried to clean it off, but it wouldn't come off.
Just doing something small as standing in front of the class to do show and tell. I wouldn't look up. I wouldn't make eye contact with anyone. I would hold my toy really tight because I knew my toy loved me, even if they didn't.
Here comes Blackie. Here comes Tar Baby. I remember one in particular, they used to say, you stay in the oven too long. And that was really hurtful.
They would do it every single day without let up. On the playground, in the classroom, in the cafeteria, just constantly you got it. So I didn't really have a high self-esteem.
It was so damaging. It made us feel like we weren't wanted, that we were less than.
My mother and her friend, we were driving somewhere, and she's bragging on me. She said, my daughter is beautiful. She's got great eyelashes, she's got the cheekbones, she's got great lips. And then she's going on and she adds, could you imagine if she had any lightness in her skin at all? She'd be gorgeous. And just that last little part, just all that pride that I had about her, you know, having her brag on me, just dissipated. And I think that moment is when I really became aware.
She'll be the smart child. And why is she the smart child?
Because she is white.
Okay. Show me the dumb child. And why is she the dumb child?
Because she plays.
Well, show me the ugly child. And why is she the ugly child?
Because she plays.
Show me the good-looking child. And why is she the good-looking child?
Because she likes skating.
I think I remember most saying that, you know, if I had a little girl, I didn't want her to be dark. I remember saying that. I didn't want her to be dark like me.
When you're around so many people that you trust, you know, simply because you're looking at another black person, you're thinking, oh, they're black, I'm black. You know, they're not gonna have anything derogatory to say about me. But when you live so many years with people having certain judgments relative to your skin tone, you start to believe it.
A friend of mine had recently had a baby. And so, you know, it was my first time seeing a baby, and the baby was beautiful. And she said, girl, I'm so glad she didn't come out dark. And when she said it, it felt like a dagger, like someone took a dagger and stuck it in my heart, because I was used to expecting hearing things like that from other races. But this was someone that I considered to be my sister.
Skin color amongst the black community is a huge issue in our time.
This is not a phenomenon. It's just a reality in the black culture.
I believe we didn't like ourselves. I'm sure it started with slavery, but I think we kept the vicious cycle going.
I mean, you know, dark-skinned women, I don't really like dark-skinned women. Like, they look funny beside me. So, you know, I'd rather not date a dark-skinned woman.
You rather a light-skinned girl?
Yeah, light-skinned pretty girl, long hair, don't care.
My experience with black men has been, I'm exotic, I'm beautiful, they're fascinated by me. Behind closed doors. But when it came to dating, coming to the front door, taking me out in public, doesn't happen.
The darker you are, it's more of a sexual approach. It's more of a relationship without much meaning sort of approach than it is, I could get married to that woman and have a few kids.
All my lighter friends always had those boyfriends. They always were seen together, but if somebody wanted to date me, it was, I'll meet you after school. It was more of a hidden thing. Nobody ever wanted to just be with you.
There are places I've gone that there are just a lot of whites, and they would tell me, you have such beautiful skin. Is that your hair? Did you dye? Is that your natural color? And you know, it's really questionable to me. Why is it that they think that I'm so beautiful and my own people don't see any beauty in me at all?
I was once on CNN debating the whole controversy about Beyonce's L'Oreal ad when, you know, a picture of her just in motion was placed against a picture of her in print. You know, everybody said, oh, there's no way that they didn't lighten her skin. And, you know, I just don't want to believe that that is still happening this day and age.
You got that good hair, too. You like what? I like girls with that light complexion look. Oh, you're a moron. I can't help it. What, being a moron? Yeah, that too.
Several years ago, I had decided I wanted to wear a fro. I remember one young lady said to me that if she had her hair look like that, she would have to cover it. And I said to her, well, you take up the perm out of your hair, that's exactly what it looks like. And she said she has never seen her natural hair, because from she was small, her mom has always had her put something in it.
It doesn't look clean, I feel like. It looks like nasty almost. Like if you just like roll out of bed and your hair is like nappy, it's the most disgusting, like unclean thing.
I've had issues with having longer hair since a small child. And it did come from black kids.
Being in school, there was just such a separation among girls who were lighter skin and girls who were darker skin.
It was really bad because in junior high school, the nair, some people I knew, threw balls of it in their hair just to take it out. Yeah, so we were separated and it caused a lot of friction amongst children, which now as an adult just seems stupid to me.
The racism that we have as a people amongst ourselves is a direct backlash of slavery. The house niggas versus the field niggas, the paper bag rule. If you're darker than a paper bag, you know, and the whole thing, it's like we as a people were so disenfranchised that we adopted some of that, a lot of that.
I think the problems within the black community has to do more with our lack of unity. We don't really see each other as being part of the community, partly because we don't have a language. We don't have something tangible aside from our skin color to say, I am part of you, you are part of me. In a black community, it's like, no, I'm not black, I'm Caribbean. Or I'm not black, I'm Haitian. You're black.
Rise, dark girls. Rise.